just for you. It's 62. WGPR-TV 62, Detroit.
Of the matter and take a good look at your lifestyle. It may be killing you.
Take 10 America to learn the metric way. It's a simple system based on tens that you can start today. Efficient, more accurate, more universal too. It's good for our economy, our country, and for you. Now there's the meter. It's a little more than a yard. You think about it that way, it's really not so hard. The leader. Now please don't sell it short. It works out fine if you keep in mind it's a little more than a quart. The gram. About the weight of a single raisin. About the same as a paperclip. Now isn't that amazing? Celsius. The temperature scale you see. A summer day is about 25. A cold day is -3.
Take 10 minutes to learn the metric way. Write Metric Education, P.O. Box 111, Washington, D.C. 20044.
Take 10.
This message has been brought to you as a public service by this station and the U.S. Office of Education.
My name is Carolyn Gallot, and I'm a country director for the Peace Corps in Western Samoa. The help of our Peace Corps volunteers is important to the people of this beautiful land. In agriculture, education, and health, the Peace Corps today is people helping people. In the next 2 weeks, Peace Corps recruiters will be in your area looking for people like you to help. If you're interested in the Detroit area, call Collect 226-7928 for information.
I'm Mike Waring, alias the Falcon. Detroit. Detroit's in the state of Michigan, which means great water. Its motto, when freely translated, says if you're looking for a pleasant peninsula, brother, you've found it. Draw an 85-mile circle around Detroit, and inside of it are the plants that make 9/10 of the American automobiles. There are other facts you find only in police records. Let's take a look at one of them in the making. It was a small hotel on a quiet side street. I'd been staying there for a few days. This particular night, I got in late. Come and get it, Peggy.
I'm not Peggy.
Yeah, I can see that. She was short, plump, and around 60. Things are looking up. What happened to her, anyway?
She's on vacation.
Tell her not to hurry back.
Good night, sir.
Good night. Can I have a key for a paying guest, McNally?
I'm Harris, sir. What was the name?
Waring, Mike Waring.
Of course, Mr. Waring.
What happened to McNally?
He quit, sir.
Oh, it's rather sudden, wasn't it?
I really don't know, sir.
Oh.
Good night, Mr. Waring.
Good night. On your feet, Maxwell. Rise and shine.
Oh, I must have dropped off. I'm sorry, sir.
Well, this is Maxwell's shift.
Well, he had to knock off for the day.
Why?
Well, his kid got sick.
Oh. Oh, did it again.
I beg your pardon?
I forgot to put my car in the garage. Hold everything.
officer.
Yeah.
Something's going on in that hotel.
What are you talking about?
The staff has been switched.
Well, that happens.
I asked the elevator operator what happened to the regular, Maxwell. He said Maxwell's boy is sick.
Who kids get sick?
Maxwell doesn't have any kids.
Inside. Maxwell was a bachelor.
I don't know how long I drew a blank, but when I came to, the first thing I saw was my contact, James Carew.
Welcome home.
Thanks for the lift.
Think nothing of it. Don't bother helping him up. He'll only fall down again.
What time is it?
11:03.
Oh, I've been out almost an hour.
You'll be in a lot longer than that. What was the quarrel about?
Carew and I?
If that's Carew.
That's James Brotherton Carew.
Was the fight about his middle name? Oh, all right, Waring. We know you're the Falcon. You're working for the Treasury. How does that entitle you to lay on the floor next to a corpse?
Carew was about to give me a list of names, dates, and amounts.
Whose names? Which dates? What amounts?
Amounts of undeclared income. Names of local racketeers who hadn't paid taxes on those incomes.
I'll admit we have a local racketeer or two. Why this hotel?
Carew was afraid he was being watched. He thought if I checked in here and waited, he could meet me without being spotted.
He was wrong.
And dead wrong.
I was behind the desk, just as I am now, Mr. Waring, when they came in. I didn't get a chance to take a look at them. Then the big man pointed the revolver at me. It was most distressing.
Must have been.
Then he ordered me to show him the way to the basement. I did. What could I do? And then Peggy and Maxwell were taken along too, and then we were all locked up down there.
Then the substitute staff took over.
We would probably still be there if I hadn't remembered the little window behind the furnaces. It was a terrifying experience.
You're okay now, Mr. McNally.
Excuse me.
We've about got it all now, Waring. They moved in, locked the regular staff in the basement, and waited for Carew. When he showed, they knocked him off, took the list, and got out.
Yes, but there's only one item left.
What's that?
Who are they? A thing of beauty is a joy forever.
What's that?
Forget it.
Somebody got wise to the hotel, Waring. Carew maybe talked a little too much.
Well, they'll never talk again.
So they staked out, set a trap.
There's the cop that was planted in front of the hotel.
Max Jenkins, alias Max Breen, alias Max Morgan.
He liked the name Max.
Yeah. Garrity, we want a boy named Jenkins, Breen, or Morgan. Take your choice. He's been printed. We got his mug up in the gallery. We want him fast. Slap him with impersonating an officer charge. We're in a big hurry. Got any more for us, Waring?
No, the rest of them must have been camera shy.
When we get this phony cop Max, he ought to be good for a few leads.
If he talks. I'd like to get them all down here for a little tea and conversation.
Life is not a conspiracy to make everybody happy.
You're right. Well, I guess I'll run back to my hotel. If you get any leads, why just...
You'll hear about it.
I'd give half your pension to get my hands on a crystal ball.
Stop spending my money. What would you do with it?
Find out what our pigeons are doing?
I want the police. Yeah, it's an emergency.
Hello. I want the officer in charge of the Terrace Hotel case. I want him fast. Yeah, I'll hold on.
Hello, what is this, a gag? Grady,
have this call traced fast.
Hello, who is this?
Yeah, sure, I was at Max's place.
And
there was a squad car parked out in front.
He called the police?
There was a squad car parked in front and a meat wagon.
Hell.
By this time, he's holding down a slab. A cold stone slab at the morgue.
Stop it.
This is news to you?
Of course it's news.
I was just asking.
You've asked. Jack Walsh.
He doesn't answer his telephone.
He got us into this. He can...
He doesn't answer his telephone, so he's not in his apartment.
Then where is he?
I haven't been notified. You know, we're sitting here like a couple of clay pigeons waiting to be knocked over. Maybe we're foolish. Nobody can identify us as being in on the job, with Max dead and Walsh missing.
That's right.
Except the Waring guy.
Yes. Except Waring.
Yeah, wouldn't everything be nice if he kept his mouth shut?
Why should he keep his mouth shut?
Sometimes a guy can be persuaded. Yeah, that's where you come in.
But suppose he won't listen?
Well, there's always another way.
No.
No, not unless it becomes necessary. If he keeps his mouth shut, we're fine. If he don't, we're in trouble.
All right. I'll try.
Sure, you try. And I'll back you up one way or another.
Surely safe and doctor sound.
Hey, look at this whole
arm and the nerve. Are you afraid of being here in these parts?
They can defeat.
Okay, Sal and Arnie, you germs, clean up your act.
Oh, yeah.
She's really quite right. You see, according to our latest
lab report... And why don't you go back to your Bunsen burners?
There ain't room in this town for the four of us.
She's right, Sal. Stop multiplying.
2 times 2 is 4. 2 times 4 is 8.
You dim bulb. Like this. At room temperature, us joints can multiply like wildfire.
Especially if you leave the food lying around over 2 hours.
We're surrounded. What do we do?
Well, according to our lab report, all right. No more Mr. Nice Guy.
Dr. Sound.
Grab the pamphlet.
Refrigerate leftovers.
Refrigerator.
Clean utensils.
You can have this book free. Just write Food Safety, Washington, D.C., 20250.
Yep.
Yes, thank you, sir. The assistant manager took over for a while, and I had a chance to lie down and rest.
Oh, could I have my key, please?
Here you are, Mr. Waring.
Thank you. You ever seen her before?
I don't think so.
Well, I don't think you'd forgot if you had.
Good night. Night, Mr. Waring.
Just taking care of a little insurance, shall we? Angel, we can talk right here.
It's hard to get started.
Well, let's start with Carew. His corpse was found lying just about where your feet are. You were saying?
He was already dead when we got here. Jack Walsh wanted to play a joke on Carew. We'd surprise him for a laugh.
But nobody laughed. Whose idea was this whole thing?
Jack Walsh.
I met him as Harris, the phony hotel clerk. Let's go and see if Mr. Walsh is still laughing.
We can't. He isn't in his apartment. I don't know where he is.
You know, your story has just about enough holes in it to make it sound possible.
Thanks, Mr. Waring.
Call me Mike. I answer to Mike quick. Keep talking.
What?
We have a visitor out on the fire escape behind the drapes.
Who?
We're at a disadvantage. We're standing in the light. He's out there in the dark. We've got to equalize that. Keep talking.
I'm afraid. Mike, can he hear us?
We would have had bullets by now if he could. Now listen to me. When I say now, I'm going to douse that lamp. I want you to get out of that chair and get out of it fast. Do you get it?
Yes.
So I feel that most understand us to come to now. There you are. I'm going to get the drapes. It's all over. He's gone.
I was scared.
Sure. But you were fine. You didn't even scream. Hold it, Angel. For one thing, McNally will be up here any moment. For another.
Yes.
What's your name? We were expecting you.
Expecting me? Mr. Waring.
Please, please, you want to wake up the entire hotel?
I demand an immediate explanation.
There was a prowler out on the fire escape a few moments ago that just took a couple of shots at us.
Good heavens.
Yeah. The young lady was sitting right in this chair when the barrage started. Here, every one of these bullets were intended for her.
Mike.
Apparently somebody doesn't love you very much, Angel.
I don't know who would...
Maybe they didn't want me to make conversation with you.
Oh, this is indeed dreadful. I shall immediately call the police.
Yeah, you do that. Let's go.
But, Mr. Waring, where are you and the young lady going?
Well, we're
going
to keep moving.
Why?
Because it's harder to hit a moving target. So long. Could you make us a couple ham and cheese sandwiches, please? Well, this will keep us out of the rain for a while.
It isn't raining.
No, but it might start any minute. Well, it's nice we weren't even followed. That bothers you?
No, I...
You expected us to be followed, didn't you? By whom?
Bill Grace.
Well, the phony elevator operator. When you picked me up, he was standing in the same doorway. What, are you working together?
Yes.
What at?
Bill and I thought if we could get you to agree not to identify us, we'd be safe.
And you're still working at them?
I suppose so.
Well, you've certainly got a lot to work with. Supposing you fail, then what happens?
Bill said he'd...
Try killing me.
I never agreed with him, even before I got to know you. And now...
Okay, Angel, I'll buy that. Now to get back to Mr. Walsh. I don't think he'd leave town without saying goodbye.
Ticket for Greensville, please.
Return trip?
No, one way. I'm not coming back.
I don't think the taxpayers would approve.
Don't tell them. Glad you could drop in.
Nah, don't be bitter. Green. I've got a girl in the other room. I want her buried for the night.
Why?
So she'll be alive in the morning?
That's easy. I'll stick her in a hotel we use, send a uniformed man with her.
Fine.
Something else isn't fine at all. We picked up that phony cop Max you identified with two bullets in his heart.
Well, back to a dead end there.
Yeah.
Well, let's hope we get to the next one before. Green, what does the name Jack Walsh mean to you?
Nothing right now.
Well, first thing in the morning, make it mean something. And while you're at it, put out a call on a hood named Bill Grace. He was the substitute elevator man. Good night.
Garrity, there's a girl outside with Waring. I want her stashed away until morning.
I'm not worried. Sure, I had it bad for a while. But now with you furnishing an out and furnishing the dough, what have I got to worry about?
Wait a minute. I got a gun.
You got anything for me this morning, Green?
I've got the Bureau of Criminal Identification on the line right now.
Jack Walsh, alias John Kiermeyer, alias James Anderson. Three local indictments, but no convictions. Present whereabouts unknown.
Much obliged.
Nice so far.
There's more. I got this from the crime index. Walsh worked on small and big cons. His modus operandi was posing as an out-of-towner in Detroit on visits. He hit the hotels, mostly. His last known address, Greensville Motel, Greensville, Michigan.
You paint a beautiful picture, but it needs one more little touch.
I sent a man down to the railway station with Walsh's description. This might be the one little touch.
Why, yes, there's the Belle Island station. Why, yes. We sold a one-way ticket to Greenville last night to a man answering that description.
Thanks. Baby was in Detroit last night, bought a ticket home. Shall I have the Greensville police pull him in?
No, not yet. I'll need him for bait.
Going fishing?
Yeah, you could call it that. I'll pick the girl up on the way over.
I'll phone the man on duty. Tell him to release it to you. She bait too?
Yes, but I'm not quite sure for who, though.
Garrity, I want to,
Angel, over there's a phone booth. Call my hotel and tell them where I'll be.
All right, Mike.
Two tickets to Greensville, please.
A round trip?
I hope so.
Jim. How many points?
17. You are one lucky man, Mr. Walsh.
Lucky? That's my deal. Manny.
Huh?
Where was I last night?
Detroit. I mean, you was here. All night you was here.
Why, you blundering idiot.
Please, Mr. Walsh. I just wasn't thinking.
Cut him.
Yeah, sure, Mr. Walsh. I'll cut him.
Where was I last night?
Oh, you was here, Mr. Walsh.
What was I doing?
Going through the accounts, making up the payroll, and part of the time you was working in one of the cabins.
I didn't leave here at any time, did I?
Oh, no, Mr. Walsh.
Walsh.
Yes.
Well, Angel, this case has just run down. Like a clock that somebody wound and left forgotten.
Do you know who's guilty?
Oh, sure. I've known for a long while, but I've got no proof.
And you've come here for that proof, then?
With a little luck, yes.
Then you still believe we killed Carew?
Juries don't buy beliefs. Let's go in and say hello to Mr. Walsh.
Customers, Mr. Walsh.
Waring. Hold it.
Put yourself down over there. Well, aren't we nervous, Mr. Walsh?
What do you want, Waring?
Mike!
Oh, I don't want a knife in my back. Or should I call you Mr. Kiermeyer or Mr. Anderson?
Oh, you know.
Yes, I know. And so do the police. If this guy presses that knife any harder, gets my back, he's going to buy you a one-way ticket to the chair.
Mr. Walsh, is he telling the truth?
I don't know.
But Mr. Walsh! Oh,
Waring must be crazy.
No.
Mr. Walsh, maybe if I went after you'd get your brains beaten out, what few you've got. June, you let him here. Why?
You got me. All of us into that business at the hotel. We're facing a murder charge, Walsh.
And you wanted company.
Max is dead. Somebody shot him.
Max?
I don't know where Bill Grace is.
He's dead, too. No, Mr. Walsh.
Who are you?
It can only be. You killed Carew before we got to the hotel. Took the list from him. Then you tried to get rid of us, all of us. Because if we told the police that Carew was already dead, you... Now you have to get rid of us.
Yes, my dear. Mr. Grace saw me try to shoot you, my dear Miss Mason, at the hotel. He came to me and attempted blackmail.
So you killed him?
Yes. Just as I shall have to.
Meet Mr. McNally. I think it's time we left for the station, Angel.
Waring, when the cops were here to pick up McNally, you didn't turn me over to them. Why?
Well, so it would look better for you when you turned yourself in. With an offer to testify against the big guys who hired you to grab Carew and that list that he was getting.
Thanks, Waring.
You know why I suspected McNally, Angel? Because all you characters tried to do was conk me, not kill me. Why? Obviously, you're not killers, or I'd be dead. Then back at the hotel when McNally tried to shoot you and didn't call the police. Complete giveaway. Shall we go? I think the first thing you'd better do is straighten yourself out with the police.
Can I ever straighten myself out with you?
Well, Angel, maybe that's just a matter of time.
Traditionally, registration week is the busiest time of year at colleges and universities. But this year, the registration lines were shorter at many of the nation's black colleges. University officials say the downward trend is the result of larger numbers of young blacks enrolling at traditionally white colleges. Many fear this may have a damaging effect on black American culture. To offset the problem, a number of black colleges have begun aggressive recruiting campaigns. A notable exception to lower enrollments at black colleges is in the Army ROTC program. Nowadays, more students are joining ROTC. As a matter of fact, since 1974, black cadet enrollment has increased by 40% at the more than 20 historically black universities which host the program. But there is concern about the future.
And particularly in black institutions, because we're at a time that we, of course, are looking for black officers in terms of both quality and quantity.
With rising costs causing problems for many college students, a major inducement appears to be Army ROTC scholarships.
It pays my tuition. It gives me $100 a month to pay for all my books and books. Nursing books are very expensive. So it helps me financially, very financially. It takes the burden off my parents.
Many black ROTC cadets are also attracted by the leadership experience they receive.
But if I go in with the experience from the Army, if I should choose, you know, to go in for a couple of years, come out and work in a hospital, they're going to look at that, and it's going to make a difference in my position. It's going to make a difference in how they look at me.
Phil Tonkin, Tuskegee, Alabama.